Hey YouTube, what's up? So right now I got a couple requests on how to make a drying rack. So I created this drying rack pretty easily, and I'll teach you how to do it as it is probably the cheapest, but it's still not relatively cheap to make it. It's the cheapest version I found of making a drying rack. It's not portable, although I think you could be able to make it portable, but it definitely is a project that definitely involves probably close to about $30. But if you can hit that price point, you can probably make one of these, and I find it to be very effective for drying stickers or whatever you please. But yeah, so this drying rack I think is 12 inches in depth, so each tray is about 12 inches. And so what I simply took is I simply took these little shelving pieces. You can find them at Home Depot. Each of these, I don't want to. I don't know what to call it, maybe fingers or whatever, costs about $2. So however large you want it is going to be multiplied by two, because it is a little more expensive. And then these racks I think ran about $5, maybe $10. And so what you're going to want to do is find something you can actually secure it to. This is screwed in right there, as you can see. As it will be permanent, you could make some other form or try to screw it into something else, but this is the best way to make shelving I've found, and it's relatively cheap, like I said. So once you have those purchased or whatever, they simply just slide in and lock into place so you can put them down there. But making these standard, I guess, trays, I could call them, was a little bit of a challenge. As you can see, they are. This kind of almost chicken wire like thing. They come in this spool. I found it at Home Depot in the garden section. But yeah, they just come in this big spool. That's a little bit extra. It was like 10 bucks, I think. So I have plenty of extra though. So maybe you could split the cost between two friends and you both could make a drying rack. But yeah, simply mine was 12 inches, so I measured out 12 inches and cut it. I wouldn't suggest using standard scissors as they wouldn't cut metal very well, and this is metal, so definitely try to invest into some wire cutters or something, as I found those worked very easily. And you know, I put these little metal, I think they're for insulation, little metal pieces in them as to kind of create a support so it is a little bit more stiff, so it doesn't bend. I have this one that kind of has gotten warped from laying stuff on it, so I definitely suggest trying to find something. I just found those laying around. You could probably straighten out a coat hanger or something to do that. But yeah, you can definitely use a variety of things. This is just what I found to be easiest, and it's pretty straightforward, you know, cutting and measuring it to your specifics. Like I said, it's gonna run you probably about 30 bucks, but it's definitely a good project to have, or good little expansion piece to workshop or whatever. And I know I've found a good amount of use for it as time has gone on. And if you have any suggestions that would make maybe this better, or you can I give to me and I can relay to all of you guys, definitely hit me in the comments. Leave a like, leave a favorite, do what you do. That's gonna do it for me. Comrade, subscribe. Peace.